My name is Jonathan Taylor from the Move Golf Academy in Munich, Germany. And today I've been asked to explain some of the reasons and better the cures for a shank or socket. A shank or socket, if you understand it, is basically when you hit unintentionally the golf ball out of the hosel of the golf club, which will make it move virtually at a 45 degree angle to the right. This is a very emotional shot because it's not something that you are actually trying to do. And this is one of the reasons that you find yourself able to do it quite easily. In truth, there's really two major reasons for a socket. One of them is a physiological or physical reason. What's actually happening is you're changing the path of the club head. Rather than the club head moving along a path where the golf ball makes impacts the center of the club face, you change the club path unintentionally, moving the socket towards the golf ball. Now this can happen when the club is moving quite extremely from out to in, therefore the socket passes the ball before you impact it. It can also happen if you're moving quite extremely from in to out, so you're actually sliding across and catching the socket. And it can happen just by a small movement towards the ball. So there's really three major changes in the path direction which will cause a socket. What does that mean in your golf swing? Well, quite simply, when you're moving your golf club around your body, you're either moving it with your arms up and down, which will create a what we call a two-plane swing, or you're moving it with your body and your arms around an axis, which we're all trying to do in the modern game and what we call a one-plane swing. Either way, it's easy to change the plane with too much or the wrong timing of your arm swing. By moving your arms up and down, you're automatically making a pretty flexible plane, which will help you to come from the outside or the inside without any particular problems. At the same time though, even if you are moving your body as the center, just a little acceleration of your arms at the wrong time will move the arms away from the plane line and therefore bring you across the ball and make a shank or a socket a very probable result. The last thing to also look at is spine angle. When you're moving your golf club around you, you want to try and keep your spine angle constant. If you move down into the ball, there's also a chance of pushing the club into the ball and therefore also getting a socket in the golf swing. So physiologically, what you're trying to do is keep your arms connected to your body, keep your arms passive and move the club around your body in the same plane. Don't get active with the hands. And that's the very reason that the psychology of golf also has an influence. As I said, a bad shot, a socket, is something which gives an awful lot of negative emotional stimulus to you. And this will actually help your brain to remember what you did, in this case, what you did wrongly. In order to keep your arms passive, you've got to have a passive thought process. And that means that during the downswing, you're giving your body time to do its job before you accelerate your arms. Quite simply, the socket is being caused by your arms and hands accelerating the golf club too early in the downswing and then trying to move the club onto the ball. You've got to get the ball in the way of the golf swing. That means that your body is responsible for moving the golf club. Your arms and hands are being pulled around and will only make this intuitive hit at the bottom of the golf swing. What I found that helps a lot is by using almost like a rhythm or even the sound of a bell at the top and the bottom of your golf swing to trigger the impact of your hands. What you're saying to your body is wait. I go up the first ding, down the second ding. These sounds or tones should be coming around about 300 milliseconds apart, which is around about a third of a second. So it's going ding, ding. And you don't want to be hitting down or at the golf ball any earlier than that. you should be able to set it up on a simple metronome so you can actually hear the sounds of these dings. But the trick is to actually feel that you are allowing the club to come from the top to the bottom, and you're not accelerating with your arms and hands until the club is virtually on the golf ball. The final tip that I would give you is in your practice swing, when you make a practice swing, get a kind of a feel for the time it takes the club to reach the ground. You're gonna always have the feeling that you're waiting for it. This moment that you try to accelerate the golf club, you change path. When you change path, you change the impact position of the ball on the club face. I know this was quite a lot in one lesson. Take it out on the range, give it a try, and I hope maybe this will solve your problems with the socket. All the best. Ciao.